Cutaneous T-cell lymphoma is a cancer of white blood cells, which has a predilection to home to the skin. We are really not aware of a lot of risk factors for this disease. This is not a cancer that stems from sun exposure, even though it's in the skin. In fact, we use aspects of sun exposure to treat this disease. Cutaneous T-cell lymphoma can happen at any age. However, it much more commonly happens as people go into the age of their 50s, 60s, and 70s. So early on, there may not be any symptoms at all. These just may become fixed patches or plaques on the skin. It has a predilection to appear in the bathing trunk area, that is around the buttocks, on the inner thighs, under the arms. So where the sun doesn't shine is a common place where these lesions like to appear early. However, with time, they can progress to involve any part of the skin. It's when these lesions persist, don't respond to therapy, that a dermatologist might perform a biopsy and give us insight into this possibly being cutaneous T-cell lymphoma. Early cutaneous T-cell lymphoma may be treated fairly easily with localized therapy, from creams to spot radiation therapy. When lesions extend to involve more than 10% of the body surface area, we need a more aggressive skin therapy or possibly systemic treatments such as pills. Very commonly, the patient will receive phototherapy, which is where the patient will stand in a light box and be irradiated with ultraviolet lamps that help kill the cancer cells in the skin. If the disease progresses, the patient may need treatment with photopheresis, where the blood is partially removed, separated into white blood cells and red blood cells, where the white blood cells are treated with ultraviolet light, as well as a chemical found naturally in some figs and lemons called sorolin. A recent patient of mine, a mother of three young children, had one of the more severe forms of cutaneous T-cell lymphoma. Her skin was bright red. Her face, hands, and feet were all swollen. We formulated a combination of treatments for this patient. It took a while, but about 6 months into treatment, the disease started disappearing. There was complete resolution, and we could not find a trace of disease. I'm Dr. Michael Girardi, professor of dermatology for Yale Medicine.